Alright, hello everyone, we're back with Azure Dreams. I am Master Federal, also known as SIMSteven. And I'm gone back to day one, before I did all that whole tutorial and, you know, with Kuhn and all that that we did in the last episode. So because, you know, I said I like to talk to the people town, and there's actually a few funny little lines of dialogue if you go around and look for them. Right here she says, they say children's songs are a message from God. I wonder if it's true, but I still have no idea what they're singing about. If you talk to this girl right here next to her, attack button is the X button, yay button is square button, to hurry, hurry, circle button, to jump, triangle button. So apparently children's songs are messages from God. They're also fourth wall breaking humor. So, anyways, I'm just going to kind of go around and talk to a couple people. I'm going to leave out some of the more important locations that we'll be going to later in this Let's Play. But if we talk to some of the just the normal people before we go around and before we go into the front tower for the first time, got a couple interesting lines. For example, this aunt. What, it's you, Guykou. Are you here to steal food from our kitchen again? So get out of here before I scold you. Oh, I'll bet you ate all our salted squid. I found the bottle emptied. I tell you, I took my eye off you for 1 second, and I don't know how, but you took down a full bottle. Salted squid is apparently good. Last I checked, squid was kind of tasteless, and I've actually had squid once before. At a local Italian restaurant, so I had it with some, like, Alfredo, and it's just... Squid, I suppose it's alright, but it's just kind of... No flavor, really. Not much flavor to it at all. Anyways, we go next door, talk to this professor guy, Dr. Hal, and we ask him, can you tell us about the Monster Tower? Okay, this should be in that book. And he pulls the book from the shelf, and the whole shelf falls down on us. Sorry, can I wait another time? So yeah, a little bit of comedy here. There's a couple other houses. I believe this was another one of them. Yeah, this kid's kind of a little bit of a funny line, too. Warning, dangerous person! Warning, dangerous person! My dad was telling me that long ago you attached chairs to my dad's windmill and charged money to ride it, calling it a Ferris wheel. yeah. Looks like Geico here was a bit of a Dennis the Menace when he was a little brat, and I suppose he's, even though he's an adult now, I guess he still could be something of a brat now, but that's gonna change when we go start going in the Monster Tower, becoming more of a grown-up throughout our adventure. There's one more house I want him to look in. Visited that one. There's one more with a relatively funny line, and I think that's over here, if I'm not mistaken. Just kind of giving a little bit of a tour of the town. I'll probably do a more full-blown tour of the town, probably in a future episode. Or maybe I will at the end of this episode, I'm not entirely sure. But I may or may not get to like that blog that I was talking about. Because it's going to be a blog play and all that. But I'm probably not going to get to that until, I suppose, maybe a few episodes down the road. Oh, it's only you, Guykou. Since you're only here to butter, so I'm telling you to go home. You're the one I ailed the honey and replaced it with oil, aren't you? I almost licked that oil. Echo is just a little bit of a troublemaker. I think this girl says the exact same thing every time. The thing about this game is they're always telling you to rely on your familiars and all that. Thing is, I don't really do that until much later in the game, and I don't actually rely on them. I kind of use them as support once I start climbing higher and higher and higher into the tower. But anyways, I'll probably get into that once I get into the tower. And I suppose before I suppose I'll just cut it out until I get a successful power run. Because the thing is, I'm going to... I only want to do the first floor, floors 2 through 4. Because, like I said in the last episode, the higher you go into the tower, the different things that people have to say to you when you talk to them in town. If you go out the right door of our house, we get into the bathtub, which is actually an oil drum. Ooh, a bath, so relaxing. There's actually a scene that you get if you go into that one only too many times. I might show that later, because we'll have that bathtub for a while. What I like to do, one of the first things I really like to do when I save my money, when I play through and grind money in the tower, is I like to expand my monster hut. The thing about the monster hut is it starts off with 4 squares, and I believe it expands all the way up to 32. I think you have up to 32 monsters in your hut. And because of all those monsters that you can have, the save data is actually 3 memory card blocks on the PlayStation 1. You can also upgrade your house later. And when you open this, when you upgrade your house, the safe, not only does the interior get bigger, but the safe goes from 10 items all the way up to about 50. And so, I suppose I will cut it out here and continue on once I get into the tower later and have a successful two to four floor run. And hopefully I won't get my butt handed to me like I did last time. So, I'll meet you there once I actually get a successful recording of that that two-floor run, and I'll skip through all the tutorial and stuff. So, see you guys in, it'll be about a few seconds for you, but several, probably half an hour, hour for me. So hey, yeah. Hello everyone, welcome back, and I am actually doing a voiceover for this part. Thing is, towards the end of this run, was actually a very lucky run for me. Towards the end of this run, my computer just decided to up and restart on me for no good reason. Anyways, I am just kind of doing a voiceover here, and I'm just kind of following along with that, what I was doing in this run. So right off the bat, it's actually the second take of my run, and actually ended up being so lucky that I wanted to salvage it as much as I could. But anyways, right off the bat, I picked up that iron sword and equipped it. And if you see over there, if I remember right when I was doing this, kind of like, ooh, that's lucky right there. I see a troll sword. And as you'll see later, that troll sword is actually going to be very, very valuable. But right off the bat, I got a pretty rare item that actually sells for a lot. Troll sword normally, I think, sells for 1,000 gold. But I don't know this when I'm going through the dungeon crawl right now. But that troll sword is actually cursed and will sell for about 4,500 gold. So normally, I believe troll swords are worth only 1,000 gold because that one is cursed, it's going to sell for a whole lot more. And that's one reason why I'm trying to salvage this recording as much as I possibly can. Another reason, another thing there, obviously I'm fighting a troll here, but if you can see what I'm doing there is I'm fighting at a higher elevation, and whenever you fight at a higher elevation, your attack and defense are greater than what they would normally be as if you were fighting on a level plane. I also pulled up the menu and showed the fireball that I pick up in the normal tutorial stage, because you saw my last episode. Which I don't know why you wouldn't, because this is only the second episode of this Let's Play. The thing is, I got killed by a fire elemental when I was going through the tower the first time. But what I was showing there with that fire elemental ball is magic balls in this game are incredibly, incredibly powerful. And so the fireball that I picked up was essentially going to be my ace in the hole whenever I encountered like a flame, like I just did right there and then. So in order to try and prevent myself from getting game over, I would not hesitate to use the fireball just in case I run into some trouble. Another very rare glitch happened right there. As you can see, I stepped into a monster den. However, monster dens normally happen only in rooms. So the glitch that happened is I stepped into a monster den on like the connecting pathways between the rooms. Very rare glitch, and I'm just fortunate to have salvaged my video from this run in the tower, because that normally does not happen on the walkways. As you can see, I'm pointing out a trap that I stepped on. It did not activate, but if it did, that chaos trap would have confused me and messed up my controls. And like, if I were to have attacked that Palumpa, Guykou might have attacked in a different direction, or I might just, whenever I tell him to move in one direction, he might move in a different direction. So that's what chaos does in this game. So anyways, I'm just kind of going around, and I don't know what I'm going to be doing here at this point. Is I pretty much explored this floor, and what I'm going to try to do is grind a few levels before I head up to the next floor. The reason for this is, even though there's a game mechanic that whenever you go into the tower, Guykou will always be reset to level 1. So there are items you can get later on, such as Shumuro seeds or Hazak seeds, which permanently increases stat by 1. Because of the fact that Guykou is affected by that whole level down thing every time he enters the tower, you do not want to use permanent increase items on Guykou. You also do not need to do a ton of grinding if you're just going to do a short run like I am right now. But however, I want to have that extra level or two in this run for the sake of just being able to survive the first 4 floors. And hopefully get better equipment while I'm doing this run here. So just kind of as I'm winding around, I kind of want to explain a few things and while I'm doing this bit of a voiceover. As you can see right now, I'm just pulling up the menu of showing Kun there. I believe when I was originally doing this recording, I was at this point explaining why you do not use familiar. So the thing is, when a familiar levels up, their magic also does. And familiars can have up to 2 spells, and the spells themselves have levels. So the reason I do not level up my familiars early on and do not use them whatsoever is because I when your familiars level up, their spells level up too. And if your familiar is at a higher level than their spells, then their spells will increase at a double rate. Thing is, they'll typically never be the same level as your familiar. So if let's say I had a level 8 Kun and I taught him the poison spell at level 2. If I had leveled him up to level 8, that poison spell would probably be at level 7, because even though spells can increase at a gradual rate, at a double rate, when they're not equal to the level of the familiar, spells typically never, for whatever reason, increase to the same level as the familiar. So it's like to always be one level behind. Anyways, what I'm doing right there is I'm standing in a corner and holding triangle and circle. That will skip turns, and Ko has incredible hit point regeneration rate. So when I do grinding like that, just before I reach another, before I go up to another floor, I will just sit in a corner and grind levels, wait for monsters to come to me, and thanks to Geico's incredible hit point regeneration rate, I'll pretty much typically be restored to full health before I fight each monster. So that's how I do grinding whenever I feel like grinding on the floor. As you can see, I picked up a Scorch Shield, just a little bit ago. Thing is, during these first few floors, there are very few enemies that are water elemental. And so that's why I decided to use a Scorched Shield for a little bit of extra survivability. Because the Scorched Shield, I believe, is fire elemental. Or was it water elemental? I'm not sure. But I believe it's strong against fire type monsters, just like this flame here. And because I found that, I decided to replace my wood shield for the time being with that Scorched Shield. And the thing is, I also picked up a Blizzard Sword just a moment ago. And it turns out that Blizzard Sword is cursed. So, even though I have increased attack power against water, fire elemental enemies, this water elemental sword, even though it's stronger than the Copper Sword, obviously, Copper Sword only has 2 attack power. Blizzard Sword normally has 5, and it's also strong against fire types. However, because it's cursed, I cannot take it off. That's one reason I am not going to keep it when we get to the end of this episode. However, it will be useful for this particular run, simply because of the fact that it is water elemental, and water is strong against fire. Fire elemental is strong against wind, and wind is strong against water. So that's just kind of the trinity of elementals and how they work. So I'm actually protected against fire with that Scorched Shield. I believe I am, I'm not entirely sure. But I'm also got a water elemental sword, so I do more damage against fire elemental enemies like that troll there. So as you see, I'm doing 12 damage to the troll. And because I'm using water against water, I'm only doing 11 to the plume pop. Not a major difference, but it does help, especially since this is my first run in the tower. Second try at my first run in this tower. See, the cyclone is only taking 5 damage. That's because the cyclone is strong against water. And since I'm using water elemental sword, I'm not doing a whole lot of damage. But however, he's only doing 1 damage. Cyclones are essentially tank type enemies. They do not do a whole lot of damage to you, but they can take a little bit more punishment than, say, a Palumpa or something like that. Or a strong enemy that is strong offensively. So they're stronger defensively, but they didn't do a whole lot of damage to me. And that's one reason why I did all that leveling up in the last floor. Speaking of which, I'm doing more leveling up here, from the looks of things. Again, this is voiceover. But the thing is, because I'm doing level up, because I did leveling up in the last level, well, actually, I'll explain how I do levels. I typically stand in a corner and let monsters come to me, and thanks to that high regeneration rate of, well, Geico's hit points, I typically will not be killed when I'm grinding unless I'm just completely outmatched in like a higher floor. So typically what I'll do is sit in corner, let my hit points recover, and the enemies will come to me, and I just hold triangle and circle to skip turns, and that'll just skip time. What I didn't mention so far is if you stay on a floor too long, you'll start getting earthquakes, and that's how I got booted up into the third floor when I was just sitting around grinding. The game will not let you grind for too terribly long, but you can use that to your advantage to give yourself an edge if you're trying to push the limit on how far you can go in this in the tower run that you're currently doing. So I'm kind of just going around looking for enemies. I'm not doing what I usually do, and that's sit in the corner and wait. One piece of advice that I do have when you do decide to sit around and wait is if you can find like an elevated portion in the room and it's kind of in the back, I would recommend standing just at that higher elevation and let enemies come to you, because the fact of how elevation increases your attack and defense, and attacking from a higher elevation is good advantage for when you do level grinding. Because sometimes you'll get just a whole line of monsters all at once, and that's just a good way to do some grinding. So let's say I stood in the upper left corner of the room there, and just hung out by that door, I could probably just sit and grind there. I do not recommend staying next to a door. Whenever you do grinding, I recommend staying farther back in a corner, because the thing is, magic, even though you cannot attack around a wall, diagonally through a wall, magic can, so that's why I do not recommend doing that. Staying next to the door. I always recommend standing at least a couple steps away from the door, so enemies come at you to the side, and when they get to you, they usually move diagonally one step towards you. That's kind of a bit of a tactic to use. Back there I got star glasses, and I remember explaining when I was doing this run originally that star glasses and truth glasses are the only two types of glasses in the game. The star glasses will essentially reveal the entire floor, and I believe I explained that. Truth glasses will reveal an object, and I'm just kind of breaking off, but I picked up a hammer there, a troll hammer, and that'll come in handy with an explanation I put in later, but troll weapons are usually worth 1,000 gold when you sell them, but since I picked up that cursed troll sword, even though I do not know it in the run now that you're currently watching, but troll hammers and troll swords are two of three types of weapons in the game. They also sell for a lot. And since I got that cursed troll sword, it's going to sell for a whole lot more. So that's another reason, is I got the troll sword, the troll hammer. Those are two good reasons as to why I wanted to salvage this run. The other thing is, that Aspirin Ball. That is one of the set items that I always try to keep with me in every single tower run that I do. Because the thing is, I say near the end, because I did my voice recording when I just kind of wrapped this episode up. But I say near the end that I'm going to explain Sans, but I suppose while we're waiting for that that computer crash that I had to happen, Sans essentially are something I always want to keep and use. And white sands will increase the number of charges on magic balls. The thing about acid rain balls is that they're the strongest magic in the game. They are essentially a screen nuke for anything that's nearby. It's not a good idea to use acid rain balls when you're on the walkways, because you'll only hit about a 3x3 square. However, if you use an acid rain ball when you're in a room, it kills everything in that room, because essentially anything in a room that's in the same room as you are essentially invisible, and that's why acid rain balls are so powerful. If I were to counter like a monster lair, and a whole mess of monsters normally would have spawned, unlike the glitch that happened later, if I would have got into a monster den and used acid rain ball in a room that's like that monster den, it would kill all those things, and I would get massive experience points from using acid ball rain in monster den. It's also a good way to finish off extremely powerful monsters that you might not be able to take on with your current equipment settings, so it helps to prevent you from a ruined run. And right about here is where the thing crashed. So I'm just gonna be quiet for a moment. Okay, I just had a weird error. I'm picking up where I left off. I had a really screwy computer error. As I was recording the last episode, up until this point, I was doing very good and got a lot of rare stuff. I got and very lucky here. However, my computer just kind of rebooted spontaneously, and I'm probably gonna have to do a voiceover of what I was recording up to this point, because even though my computer rebooted, my recording software saved the what I had been recording up until this point. And I really, really want to keep this run. I was going to use a medicinal herb on Fennel here. And so it increases hit points. And before I leave the tower, I was going to just use that medicinal herb on him. And let's see here. Then I was going to hatch the egg here. And I don't know if I have enough time to explain it, because what I was doing towards the end is the colors of the eggs do not matter. It's just a randomly generated color whenever you pick up an egg. But I'm pretty sure this pink egg here is a Plumpa egg, because on the first trip to your tower, you always get an egg during that tutorial sequence. And it's pretty much always going to be a Plumpa. So whenever you hatch an egg in the tower, that monster will not be permanent. Will not be one you get to keep for forever. It'll be gone once you leave the tower. However, I wanted to get a wind crystal, but this combination works out just as well. Thing is, I got this Olene here. If you lose an Olene on your familiar, it will essentially sacrifice that familiar. However, because I already have this temporary Plumpa, which is also the most common Plumpa in the game, most common monster in the game, I'm going to sacrifice this temporary monster, because I can usually get more, and because the fact that not only are they most common, you also have the most common eggs. They're also the weakest familiar in the game, so it's not a big deal for me to sacrifice this one this time around. I will definitely try to keep more familiars in the future. In future runs of the tower, I will try to make sure to get wind crystals and leave the tower properly. But this has the same effect here, and I'm going to use it on him, and because I got so much good stuff since the video of this recording was able to be salvaged. I'm going to try and salvage the voice audio of my last recording session. But yeah, I'll sacrifice this Plumpa, and as I was doing it towards the end of my computer crashed, gave the medicinal herb to Kun, and because of that, his hit points increased by one. His maximum hit points increased by one, so that's why I gave him that. Just kind of trying to cover up what happened towards the end there. But yeah, my computer crashed, and I'm going to try and salvage the audio, my voice audio, from when I did that last time. But yeah, anyways, let's just leave the tower now. I sacrificed that temporary Plumpa, and now I can properly salvage at least most of this recording. And that's also another reason why I created a backup save for this let's play. It's because in case something unfortunate like this happens. I'm selling items. You get the opportunity to do this as soon as you return home. Wands, I've never really gotten into those. I'll get into those later. I'm not going to keep this blizzard sword. And, ooh! I am very fortunate to gotten that troll sword, because it's cursed. Thing is, when you get a cursed piece of equipment, it sells for like triple or something like that from the normal price. Let's see here. If I'm remembering this right, all troll weapons are worth 1,000 gold, except for maybe the crossbow, which you have to do something special in order to get a crossbow. But the thing is, I think all troll weapons are worth 1,000. So if we compare that to the troll sword, it's almost 4.5 times as much. So that is extremely lucky. Because I know the cost of my HUD upgrade, and it's actually 4,000 gold. So that right there, I'm not going to save it for a troll or anything. I'm going to sell it, because that is very fortunate for me to have gotten that. I'm going to sell the fireball, Tumna Fruit, Star Glasses, just for a little extra pocket change. I'm not going to keep this Blizzard sword, even though it's in the first few floors. Most enemies are water elemental, or they're fire elemental, and water beats fire. I do not like cursed weapons, and I do not like elemental weapons. And I'm contemplating, should I keep the Scorch Shield or the Wood Shield? You know what? Since I'm kind of not going to play it as safe as I'm doing with this run, I'm going to sell my Scorch Shield for more money. And I'm going to keep the Wood Shield. Hopefully, I will get that Mirror Shield that I've been talking about before. And we'll see if I can salvage my voice recording. I'll probably have to do a voiceover for that. But I'm going to keep the Iron Sword and Wood Shield. And Crest Triangle, this is everything you're selling. We made 7,700 gold in 4 floors. That is incredible, I suppose. I'm going to keep the Troll Hammer just because I like to put one in the safe. I'm going to save one till later. Blah, 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 blah. She explains that the first time around whenever you do that tower run. But, yeah. You can store items in the safe, and I'll be doing that just in a moment. If you remember at the end of the last recording when I got that game over, well, this is the same exact dialogue scene. I'm just going to skip through that. Since I did not keep that Paloonpa, unfortunately, he's not going to be here. Just kind of going to explain this right now before I end this episode. I always bring 3 items into the tower. I always have 3 preset pieces of equipment whenever I ever bring in the tower. Sword and Shield are obvious, but that Acid Rain Ball I picked up, again, another very, very fortunate run for me to get that Acid Rain Ball, because that's one of 3 items that I always keep with me when I always go up to the tower. Did not get a Gold Sword, did not get a Mirror Shield, but I was not really expecting to get those in my first run. However, Acid Rain Balls are a bit more common. They're also one of the strongest magics in the game. So, it's actually the strongest magic ball in the game. However, it has 1 charge whenever you pick one up in the tower. This is very important later when we get into Sands and powering up your equipment. But like with Fenrir, when I get White Sands, I always use them on this Aspirin Ball, and that's why I always bring it with me. I just power this up, Gold Sword, Mirror Shield. When I get those, that will always be the stuff I bring in. I will be replacing the Gold Sword later, but the thing is, I have to get a very, very rare weapon. And there are tricks to use in order to get that very, very rare weapon. For now, though, I'm going to open the safe, toss that Troll Hammer in. It'll actually come in handy later. I'm going to keep that around because I can use that Troll Hammer to get a crossbow later, a Troll Crossbow. So trolls can use 3 different kinds of weapons. The hammer, the sword that I sold, and the crossbow are 3 different types of weapons that a troll can use. And I'm probably going to keep at least 1 hammer, 1 crossbow, and 1 sword just in the safe at all times, because I like to have a little variety when I use a troll. Even though trolls are not exactly the strongest familiars to have, they do have a little bit of extra perks to be able to equip different weapons. But anyways, yep, I have 2 save files. This second save file is a backup, just in case, for whenever I do Let's Plays. In case something unfortunate happens, like my computer crashing on me. But anyways, I'm going to end this episode here, unless I get that little special cutscene when I go out into the bathtub. Oh, there it is. Sometimes when you go out in the bathtub, when your house has not been upgraded up there, you see these little 2 girls walking back there, and it's like, oh, you see him there? He's taking it back. Giggle, giggle, giggle. But it feels good like this. Guykou must be an exhibitionist. Anyways, saving the game here, calling it an end of the episode. Thanks for watching. Bye.